Hi everyone, Anthony Fantano here, internet's busiest music nerd, and it's time, not for an album review, for an EP review. Zamuto, Idiom Wind. Zamuto is a project spearheaded by singer, songwriter, multi-instrumentalist Nick Zamuto, one half of the experimental music duo The Books, who actually came out with one of my favorite albums of 2010, The Way Out. That's it right there. And there. Nick Zamuto has released music under a solo capacity before, but most of it was before he actually started releasing full-length LPs with The Books. So this EP is a return back to that solo capacity, but Nick is not really playing the same material that he was years ago when he was releasing music under this name. There are elements of folk and electronica and noise flowing throughout these tracks, and the singer-songwriter element that sort of popped its head up a lot more on The Way Out shows up on this EP in full force. The first track to come off of this EP is the title track, and it starts with some really kind of wavy, airy chords rising and falling really quickly, and then these strings sort of fly in to back it up, and they sound very, very tender, very beautiful. Then all of a sudden this booming bass guitar comes in, and Nick Zamuto's really kind of friendly, boyish vocal takes my ears on a tour through all these really pretty sounds. And in the lyrics, I kind of feel like he's giving maybe a little bit of life advice. He's talking about a person's education and how it's not worth a damn, how this person is also kind of headstrong, surrounded in tragedy. It's easily my favorite song off of this EP because I'm as enthralled with the song and the lyrics as I am the sounds that surround it. This track and the other tracks on here too feature a really kind of odd mix, and it gives the song kind of an interesting character, like the drums. The hi-hat is just so loud and just so in my face, whereas the snare drum sort of seems to be coming in under that, and the bass drum sometimes feels like it's just non-existent. The music gets even odder on the second track, F-U-C-3-P-O. Great title. On this song, samples sort of come into play, which makes it kind of feel like the most Books-esque song on this EP. You've got a kind of funny sample starting things off talking about the human race, and it may be sampled, maybe it's not, but I kind of feel like these very watery, swirling vibraphones that pop up in the background here and there on this track may be lifted from something else. Over that, Nick Zamuto's voice is just kind of manipulated with all these robotic vocoder vocals. And those aren't even half the sounds that pop up in this track. There are just like harsh shots of noise, all sorts of inexplicable textures and timbres. It's like half of the sounds in this track were created by like a mad sound scientist in his underground lair. Mwahahaha. Lightning bolt. Lightning bolt. Some of the moments on this track feel so overwhelming, it's kind of like getting a bucket of bolts dumped on your head. And I kinda sorta mean that as a compliment. The last track on the EP has a really nimble beat, and it grooves hard. And it's got this really idiosyncratic quality to it, as all these sounds are kind of pushing along in this really rhythmic manner. The vocals are kind of singing in this very monotone, cultish delivery. The more I listened to the track, the more it kinda sorta reminded me a little bit of They Might Be Giants. And there are a lot of noises on this track too, but they all kind of melt into each other in a really interesting way. Sometimes they swirl, they bleed into one another. Sometimes I kind of feel like the goal of this EP was to throw as many sounds, as many noises into some of these tracks as possible, but still maintain some kind of semblance of musicality. I think the one downside to the third track is that it ends a little abruptly for me. I kind of feel like it repeats itself a little bit too much towards its finish and then just kind of... Still, it drums up some interesting sounds. I do have some other complaints about this EP, though. I kind of feel like I'm just on the fence with the overall sound and recording of this thing, though I do think Zamuto is going for something pretty bold, pretty noisy, something that is evolving past what the Books have been doing recently. It still ends up sounding kind of demo-ish, kind of thin, because there are some spots on here where I'm just hearing a ton of sounds that I feel like would come across so much better if there was just more space in between them. This recording is just kind of claustrophobic, and that doesn't really complement all the subtleties I hear on some of these tracks, like I may hear an acoustic guitar or something, or some odd vocal samples murmuring away in the background that I wish I could hear a bit more. And I do kind of run into the problem with this EP that I do with most EPs, and that's leaving this thing feeling kind of hungry for more. So overall, I did think this EP was really good, though. Would listen again, and I'm really looking forward to more music coming out of this project. Kind of feeling a light 7 on this, but what do you think about it? Do you love it? Do you hate it? Why? And what should I review next? Anthony Fantano, Zamuto, forever.